I recently did a video, in fact, a couple of videos on common lies in nutrition. And it was one of the lies that I touched on was the issue around saturated fat. And oh boy, did I get some pushback. And that's understandable. In fact, I expected it because I spent my whole life avoiding saturated fat. Because why? Because apparently it causes heart disease, it clogs up your arteries, it makes you fat, makes you obese, and it's very unhealthy. And we've been taught that and we believe it. The problem with believing is the word believe. It's a belief. It's not necessarily an understanding or a knowledge. So in this video, I'm going to talk to you about saturated fat, where our ideas or our beliefs actually came from, and what the current research is actually saying. And I'm going to read to you from this article, review article, put out by the American College of Cardiology. Okay, that is the professional organization that keeps cardiologists, heart surgeons, up to date with research and information and keeps their level of education current. I'm going to read to you from this, and then you tell me in the comments why you think we believe what we believe. Anyway, let's get to it. Welcome to Shape Fixer. I am Andrew. I'm a nutritionist. I have had my share of heart problems. That's been covered in other videos. I was slated for heart surgery and I did not go through with the surgery. I changed my diet and I resolved all my problems, all my heart problems. But why did I, and probably most of you, spend my whole life believing that saturated fat was the boogeyman, big evil nutrient? If we go back to the late 1970s, 1977, in fact, when the food guidelines, the official government food guidelines in America were first issued by Congress, they were based around the advice of mainly somebody called Ansel Keys, who had done some studies around the world and looked at diets sort of national and on national level, country level, national diets, traditional foods, how people eat, and they're also looking at their rates of heart disease. And he came back and said, according to his data, which he didn't share, he just shared his findings, according to his data, countries that eat a lot of saturated fat have a lot of heart disease. Therefore, it became kind of following logic that the American government told people to cut out fat, to cut out saturated fat in particular, and therefore eat more carbohydrates, more grains, and move towards a plant-based diet, because saturated fat mostly comes from animal products. That's where that came from. Now, there, since then, his data over the years has become publicly available and researchers have been able to look at it, and a lot of what he said was complete misrepresentation of the actual data that he found. He cherry-picked the data. He left out a lot of countries where the finding did not agree with what he wanted it to say. He was a very religiously inclined vegetarian. He was convinced that vegetarianism was the way his God wanted us to eat, and therefore he was looking for the answers that would fit with his beliefs. And it turns out that the countries that he quoted, where he said they were eating lots of saturated fat, were the countries that were eating a lot of baked confectionaries, cakes and biscuits, which have butter in them. But they are sugar. They are high in sugar, high in refined wheat. But it can't be the sugar and the wheat that's causing heart attacks, because sugar and wheat comes from plants and God wants us to eat plants. So we know that's not that. Therefore, it must be the butter. Therefore, saturated fat gives you heart disease. And that was the beginning and end of that belief. And to this day, what are we, 50 years almost, 48 years later, most of us still think saturated fat is going to cause us heart disease. So it suits the food industries for us to think that, because they produce a lot of very cheap processed carbohydrate plant-based foods, particularly from grains. And the department that is in America that is responsible for updating the food guidelines every 5 years or so is the US Department of Agriculture. Conflict, anyone? So where are we with saturated fat and what is the current view? It turns out there are no studies at all that show that saturated fat actually contributes to heart disease and is actually bad for you. Now I'm going to read, as I said I was going to, this article, Saturated Fats and Health, and I'm going to put a link to this article in the notes below the video here, so you can actually download it and read it for yourself. In the Journal of the American College of Cardiology, Saturated Fats and Health, a reassessment and proposal for food-based recommendations. Now remember, this is a sort of educational paper for cardiologists, for heart surgeons and heart specialists and doctors to read to be up to date with the science. Now the scary thing is that this paper was issued in August of 2020, and at the time that I'm making this video, that is getting on for 5 years ago. It's 4.5 years ago. And yet, the odds are that if you go to your doctor and ask them for recommendations about a heart-healthy diet, the first thing they're going to tell you is to not eat saturated fat. So, new knowledge seems to take a very long time to percolate its way down through society, and I think this comes back to the idea that knowledge and belief are not the same thing. Belief is not questioned. And once a piece of information is kind of really embedded in our minds and it's ingrained in our minds and it's something we've known, in inverted commas, for a very long time, it becomes a belief. And when it's a belief, you can't move it. So this is really tricky. So here we go. Let's read what this says. The recommendation to limit dietary saturated fat intake has persisted despite mounting evidence to the contrary. Most recent meta-analyses of randomized trials and observational studies found no beneficial effects of reducing saturated fat intake on cardiovascular disease. So reducing fat makes no difference. Whole fat dairy, so butter, cheese, red meat and even dark chocolate are fatty acid rich foods that are not associated with increased risk of cardiovascular disease. There is no association between those foods and cardiovascular disease. Available evidence, sorry, the totality of available evidence, so all of it, does not support limiting the intake of such foods. Well, there you have it. The American College of Cardiology advising us to eat as much saturated fat as we like, as much butter, cheese, red meat as you like, and advising surgeons and doctors to take note of this and to pass that information on to their patients. So why is it not happening? Why are we still 4.5 years after this was published getting this advice that we should avoid saturated fats? I think I know. I think because there's so much money involved. The big food companies, which are agriculture-based, plant-based, breakfast cereal and grain based, make huge amounts of money from pushing us into this type of food. It's cheap for them to produce in mass. It lasts a long time. It's easy to package. It's easy to transport. And they can sell it for huge margins. And they are in charge of the food guidelines. What guidelines do you think they're going to give? Of course, they're going to carry on with the guidelines. As they currently are. What about doctors? Why are we getting the wrong advice from our doctors? Not all doctors, of course not all doctors, but probably still the majority, unfortunately. Well, I think It's because most doctors don't have time to read things like this. They're overworked, under a lot of pressure, time limited, and rely on the pharmaceutical companies for their ongoing education, because the pharmaceutical companies will come and present to them about the latest drug they've developed. And the pharmaceutical companies have no use for healthy people. The pharmaceutical companies are companies, they're listed on the stock exchange, they have share prices, they need to make profits for their shareholders. That's what they do. And healthy people are no use to them. A healthy person is not a good client for a pharmaceutical company. So the doctors are being lied to by the pharmaceutical companies and told to push drugs to manage our bad health rather than giving us the latest information to overcome our bad health in the first place. So we're pushed. The drugs are pushed to us for money. The wrong food is pushed to us for money. And the information is here. It's here. It's all here. So go and have a look at this article and read it. I am making a video straight after this, and I'm going to list them both at the same time. So you can go from this video to my next video, which is about the real risks of heart disease, the five highest hazard factors that potentially lead to cardiovascular disease, to heart attacks and to strokes. And I think you'll be very surprised at what is not one of them. So thank you for watching. Please go and watch the second video. Have a look at this paper. Comment on the video. Engage if you want to. But please don't do it if you haven't looked at this. Okay, this is not me making this up. I'm reading this. The American College of Cardiology. Thank you very much for your time. Thank you for subscribing to this channel to keep up to date with what's going on out there. And please consider becoming a member of the channel, because I do extra videos every week where I talk more generally about current issues with my members, and I would love to have you there.